Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, ACCUPLACER Review, Elementary Algebra, Problem 64. This is the Elementary Algebra ACCUPLACER Review, Question 64. We have 2x squared plus 5x minus 3 equals which one of these following four options? Well, to start a problem like this, you do want to see if you can factor something out of each piece first. But you can't, but that's how you should start. So since I see that I can't factor something out of each piece first, I'm going to split up my parentheses. Now, I'd prefer to just see an x squared instead of a 2x squared. I start xx because it has a 2x squared. I have to do 2x in one parenthesis and just x in the other. Makes it a little bit tougher. Now, the other number on the end is just a minus 3. So that's nice because to get a 3, it has to be a 3 times 1. But where the parentheses don't both start with an x, whether you put the 3 in the first parenthesis and the 1 in the second or vice versa will make a difference. So looking a step ahead, where I see a 5 here, if I put the 3 in the second set of parentheses, it's going to be times 2. It's going to get me close to that 5. It's going to make a 6. Put the 1 here. Now that's a positive 5, so if I make the 3 in the second parenthesis positive, I'll be up to a positive 6. Make the 1 negative, 1 times x, I'll subtract 6x and minus 1x, should make a 5x, and when I'm multiplying 1, negative 1 times 3 is negative 3, so it should work. Let's try it though, let's multiply it out to verify that it does equal this. So 2x times x is 2x squared. 2x times positive 3 is plus 6x. Negative 1 times x is negative 1x. And negative 1 times positive 3 is minus 3. I'll combine my middle pieces of 6x and negative 1x. The 2x squared in front will stay in front. Positive 6x, negative 1x combined for positive 5x. And the minus 3 on the end will stay on the end. And sure enough, it does match. So my factoring was 2x minus 1 times x plus 3. Now, as I go through my list of options, I do have a match with A. Notice the order of the parentheses is different. That's okay. Putting the x plus 3 as the first set of parentheses or the second set of parentheses is really the same answer. It's being multiplied. You could arrange the parentheses in either order as long as the minus 1 is in the same parentheses as the 2x. So option A is the answer. And as I mentioned with a lot of these, since you have an unlimited test, you could just multiply out each one and see which one would multiply out to give you back the original question. That's more work than necessary. Now, in this particular problem, since the answer is A, you would get it on the first try. But if the answer were D, you'd have to do all of them to figure that out, that it would be the last one. But in this case, it is option A.